Guys, I have got the Domino 400. I am doing a city ride in the night so that you guys can see how it copes up with traffic, because tomorrow I am going to go on the highway itself. So that city thing is not going to be there. I am going to test ride the bike today night, riding in the city, how it feels from bumper to bumper, and you know, there's a whole feeling of the bike. Initial impressions riding in the city, I've ridden close to say 10 kilometers now, and the bike is peppy as hell. I filled up my tank. It took in say close to 10 liters, so 3 liters are already there, and I'm going to test the mileage also. I'm going to ride about say 60 kilometers, and then I'm going to tank up again. And I'm going to tell you what the mileage as per my riding, how it came to be. So we are waiting at the signal, and we are waiting at the signal, and traffic is bad as usual. So peace out. So good morning guys, it's 7:30 in the morning, and I've already done close to 100 kilometers on the bike last night. I've gone through bad roads, I've gone through bad highway traffic, I have gone through crawling traffic, and the bike seems really, really perfect is the right word for it. Bajaj has made the Domino 400. It has made something timeless, like the Bajaj Pulsar 220. Ease of use and practicality with top-notch performance features, ABS, slipper clutch, you name it, they have it. A digital proper console which you can see during the day and more clearly towards the night. At no point of time you will feel that, you know, you cannot read the speedo properly. KTM 390 engine, which is 373cc. What they have done is reduced the BHP, tuned it, gave it triple spark technology like the NS200, changed bits and pieces of the bike. Basically, they have actually lowered the cost, manufacturing cost. So what that gives you is a product which is so bang for the buck that you actually have nothing to complain about. So to sum it all, first let me talk about the safety features. Number one, which I feel according to me is the biggest safety feature in a bike, and I am not going to say, oh, ABS is the priority of the safety feature. Not for me. My safety feature is the tire, and that comes in the cone section. The tires they have given are not up to the mark. The amount of torque this bike creates, that's 35 newton meters, it does not do justice. I'm a guy who is heavy on the throttle when I'm having fun and when I'm not vlogging. They try to cut down on cost, they don't have mezzlers on, So Metzeler is adds cost, one. Second, durability, as in like long term ownership, it will increase the maintenance cost of the bike. Expensive tires means softer compound. A softer compound means you are changing tires on a more frequent basis. For me personally, I'm the person who can afford tires every, say, 8,000, 10,000 kilometers. I would say, if you are buying this product and if you want to have some real fun, do not keep yourself away from a Metzeler M5. I mean, those are the best tires you can have for this bike. Now, talk about 0 to 100. Here you go. Secondly, what I wanted to talk about is slipper clutch. Now, slipper clutch works flawlessly in this bike. I mean, the clutch is super light, not stretched for a second, and the suspension settings, the shock suspension settings on this particular bike is spot on. What they have given for the money is perfection to you. Nothing you can ask for. They focused this bike towards a sports tourer category. Now, we Indians have been actually deprived of a proper sports tourer. I wouldn't say this is a perfect bet. I am more of a old school kind of guy. What I am talking about is a Charisma ZMR. No, a Charisma, like the old original Charisma. That was super reliable, man. The things I have done with that bike is not to be disclosed. This is the next sports tour of India. The bike that does it all. Yes, it's not as powerful as the Duke 390. It was not meant to be. That is an all-out performance-oriented bike. Well, this is the right mix of both. Practicality, price, maintenance, and power. I straight away went to the highway at night. Two reasons for that. One, I wanted to test the lights because I can't do that early in the morning right now and show it to you guys how good the lights are. So that's there. Secondly, since there was so much of traffic because of 24th and Christmas is nearby, there was, you know, like a fleet of trucks for probably 10-15 kilometers, man. And I mean 10-15 kilometers, when you're crawling at 20 kilometers per hour, you know what kind of bashing and what kind of abuse the bike must have taken. And me being such an aggressive rider with no patience, oh man, seriously. The radiator came on once. I'm not saying that the weather was not adequate. It was actually adequate. It was freaking cold, but still, the bike did not feel stressed. You know, the bike is not done even 500 kilometers. I got the bike when the bike was, say, close to 20 kilometers, and I rode probably 30 kilometers. Got a full tank of fuel up to the brim, so that I can tell you the original mileage and the fuel efficiency of the bike. Now that's the reason I'm going there, because honestly, all my testing is done that night. I've done 100 kilometers in the worst possible conditions. Possible. I've gone crazy with it. I've gone fast with it. But just to be fair and give it a second thought, I am actually going to the highway. And shout out to Rolta Bajaj near Baguhati, one of the oldest dealerships in Calcutta, who actually gave me bike just for request. The bike was not even produced at the motor vehicle. They trusted me with that bike, and I'm really thankful to them. And the fog is crazy, man. The fog is crazy. Now, see, what I want to talk to you about is this display down here. Yeah. Now, this display, people say, is copied from the Ducati DVL, and the backlight is copied from the Ducati DVL. I usually don't care, to be very honest. If Bajaj can give me a product which can be compared to a Ducati DVL, and if everything works properly, I don't mind. I say go for this one. Go for this. The bike is nothing like a Duke 390. The characteristic of the bike is completely different. It is meant to go slow. It is meant to go fast. And this is what I like in a bike. Why do you think I like the Busa? I like the Busa because of that. You don't want the bike to be fast all the time. Sometimes you just want to sit down, enjoy, relax. You just want an adequate bike for the highway, which will give you enough juice if you have an open road or you want to have some fun on. That's about it. ABS is spot on. I have tested the ABS at 120 km per hour. I have literally jammed my rear brakes and the pulsing is there. And I did the same from the front. I literally jammed the brakes, the front brakes at 120, and yes, nothing happened. It just stopped in a progressive manner. But I genuinely feel the tires will change the whole dynamics of this bike. The tires are the only drawback of the bike, nothing else. The sound is super grunty. It is nothing like a KTM 390. It actually feels good. No, feels like, you know, you actually on something refined, and you know, that sounds good at the same time. 182,000 on road. ABS tested at 120 km per hour, both front and rear. Flawless slipper clutch. I mean, slipper clutch is a safety feature rather than a gimmick, to be very honest. Less vibes compared to the Duke. Less as in, like, they are basically close to nothing. Seriously, if you're expecting a Japanese bike, please do not do that. This is not a Japanese bike. But if you compare it with the CBR 250, yes, it is exactly like this. Then it comes to crosswinds. Crosswinds don't affect it at all. Yeah, last night when I was riding, I did not feel any crosswinds. The bike did not lose its posture. And it is actually a sports tourer. One more thing I wanted to add was, see, you see these engraved Dominum, they are beautiful. The font and the quality of material used here is really, really nice. The tank and the whole thing. The only thing which is flimsy is this. This got loose even before I got it, and the bike was only done 20 kilometers. Mirrors are good. See, you can, mirrors are good. The front is good. The indicators are of the KTM Duke 390. See, there are certain things which I don't like. They could have actually done this in a better way. But yeah, come on, yeah. What do you expect from 1,82,000, man? Then, no overheating in traffic. As I told you last night, I was in a bad situation. 15 kilometers of trucks. You know, all the two lanes were jam-packed. I'll show you a little bit of clip here. You can see the traffic. It's like mayhem right now. And this is the best test that could have been for the bike. But I am confused now where to go from. I think we should go from here. I don't want to hit anything. Because since it's not my bike. But yeah, as you can see, everything is perfect. And you'll understand how I actually tested the bike. Then I spoke about headlights being the best according to I have seen in an Indian market, Indian motorcycle. So guys, this is the light. See, when you don't switch it on, okay, then the I-beam works, so that during the day when you put it deeper, then the low beam doesn't affect the in the eye, okay. So once you put this on, this is for the night, so low beam starts working on the main. And yes, see this, you can see the beam. It's really very beautiful it is. And I'm going to do some night testing now. I'll not be making some vlog about it because I don't carry my mic right now. Tomorrow morning I'll give you a proper review of this. This is not aggressive as a Duke. If you think that this will perform like a Duke, you are sadly mistaken. This is not a Duke. This is a Dominar 400. It is not meant to perform like a Duke. It is actually a very, very good bike. See, you just see this. See, you see the Nitro shocks there. You see the quality of the swing arm, the chain. This does not look like a Bajaj product, man. This does not look like a Bajaj product. I, for one, have never ever thought that Bajaj could make something so finished. I myself was planning to take a Duke 390, and now I am having second thoughts. Why? Because this is a no-brainer, man. This is a no-brainer. My mentor, my guru, if you call it, my oldest riding partner, Mr. Faiz Ahmed, has booked this yesterday after seeing and listening to my reviews, and so did his brother. So shout out to Rolta Bajaj. They gave me the bike, and I could give them at least two customers with an honest review. And hands down, this is a thumbs up for Bajaj for making such an awesome product. I mean, look at the gauges, man. What the hell? See this, man. What the hell did Bajaj do, man? See, this is, just see this. Who does that? ABS light, Bajaj logo right here. This is just simply perfect. This look like the, you know, the feel of the bike. The feel of the bike is such that you're actually on a bigger bike. Bigger displacement bike. Tall rider, Faiz was close to say what, 6 feet tall. He was completely perfect on the bike. I am 5'5", 5'6". I can put my foot down. I'm comfortable with it.
Now I'll make you hear the exhaust sound of the bike. So this is the exhaust sound of the bike. from the RPM of the exhaust. I'm gonna show you how it actually works. See my hand and see this.